Hello everyone, this is Sudhish, and in this episode of beginner series, we will discuss on the replication feature with Azure Database for MySQL Flexible Server. We will try to cover what replication is, how replication works in MySQL Server, the read replicas which is available with Azure Database for MySQL Flexible Server, and a data-in replication with few demos. What is replication? In MySQL Server, replication would mean transfer of data from one MySQL server, which is termed as primary, to one or more MySQL servers, which is generally termed as replica. The replication configuration is based on the binary log mechanism. The primary source server is usually a dump terminal. We use the coordinates of the binary log file to read the data and replicate it to the replica server. A binary log file is a file which actually stores the changes which is there in the database. Usually these logs are used for replication as well as for point in time restore in MySQL servers. If you look at the replication architecture as you see in this picture, right, you would see the clients are actually writing the data into the database. A copy of the change has been written into the binary log. Now, the replica server has a IO thread which connects to the dump thread of the primary server and then reads its data and writes into the redo relay logs. Now, these relay logs are read by the SQL thread and been written into the replica. This is how the MySQL replication works natively. In Azure Database for MySQL, you can create a read replicas which is fully managed. The replication is asynchronous and you can go up to 10 replica servers. Replica servers are usually used where you would like to scale the read workloads. Some of the use cases are like when you wanted to use a database for your BI or reporting purpose or analytic purpose, or you have an IoT kind of an database where you write once, read many a times. Those kinds of workloads also the read replica would help. Some facts about read replicas. It's only supported in general purpose and memory optimized queues. It is created with the same compute and storage configuration of your primary server. You have an option to change it later. Billing, it's done separately as you would be doing for the primary server based upon the storage in the compute you have. For monitoring, we have a metric called as replication lag in seconds, which explains how much your replica is behind the primary server. In case of a disaster, there is an option where you can stop the replication and make the replica server read-write and continue using this server for your application workloads. Now let's get in a demo and see how we can create a replica server. For creating a replica server, you have to come to the Azure portal primary server, navigate to the replication tab, and then click on add replica. Give the name of the server and you can press OK, which will create the replica server with the same SKU as your primary server. Post creation of the replica server, you will be able to see the replica server name here. It will also give an option to delete the replica server and stop the replication. If you stop the replication, the server becomes standalone and you can no longer add it back as a replica to the current primary server. If you go to the replica server, it's a flexible server on its own, but the only difference will be that it can only read, you cannot write it to this server. If you want to change the compute, you will have an option to change the compute of the replica server post the replica server creation. Now let's see what's data in replication means. This feature helps to bring data from an on-premise and another Azure database for MySQL or from other cloud providers into Azure. So that's what data in means. So the source server can be on-prem, it can be on a VM, it can be another Azure database for MySQL flexible server or a MySQL server running in any of the other managed PaaS cloud services. Now, what are the use cases for data in replication? The first use case, or the important use case I would call it as, is for migration. When you want to migrate to Azure, you usually dump the data from the source server using MySQL dumper or MySQL dump. And then when you wanted to make the changes, what is happening to your source database get replicated into the target database, you use this Data-In Replication. This would help you to do a selective cutover of your applications from the source to the target in case of a migration scenario. The second scenario is the hybrid cloud scenario, where you can have the source on the on-prem and the target, which is on the Azure. And then using Data-In Replication, you can sync the data between the source and the target. And two different sets of applications can use these databases, which has the data in sync. Third is between the multi-cloud scenario, where you can have source in any of the cloud which is available and the destination as Azure database for MySQL. It replicate and sync the data so that they can go ahead and use it. Now, coming to the steps in Data-In Replication. For Data-In Replication, the first thing is that we go ahead and create a MySQL server, flexible server. And then we turn on the binary log and make sure that the server parameters are set so that the binary logs are not deleted on the source server. This needs to be done on the source server, wherever your source server is located. And then we put this to read-only mode to identify the position. If you are using tools like my dumper, right, which actually can take a consistent snapshot with the details of the positions being shared with you, you don't have to make it read-only. Otherwise, you'll have to make read-only and get the position of the file from the server. And then we dump the database, whichever has been backed up and whose position we know. Post that, we configure the server and ask the replica server, which is Azure database for MySQL flexible server, right, to get the data from the master server, from the position from where we took the backup. So that's where the consistent backup is important. Or if the tool you are using does not support that, then you will have to put it to read-only mode, get the status of the position, and then use that to configure, later make that server read-write. Now, let's get in the demo of Data-In Replication. For the purpose of the demo, I'm using two Azure database for flexible server itself, where my primary server or the source would be one flexible server with the name SN Demo MySQL PUB Primary, and the destination will be on the server SU Demo MySQL PUB Ripple. The first thing you would have to do is to make sure that the networking is configured such a way that it is able to communicate between the source and the target. The important connection which you would require is the connectivity from your target server to your source server. And for that, you can use the option of allowing public access from Azure database for MySQL within the Azure to the server. Doing this will make sure that any services within Azure will be able to connect to this server. So this configuration, you would have to do it on the primary server from which you are trying to connect. That will make sure that the networking bit of it is correct. I have used MySQL Workbench and connected to the primary instance and the replica instance here. Now, on the primary instance, if you see, you will have to make sure that the logbin is enabled. And then you create a user with a name and a password, which would require SSL connection, which is a safe way of connecting it. You can even do it without SSL also, and give it to have a replication, because using this user only we'll be connecting to the primary server. And then you take a dump of the database, either with a consistent backup with tools like MyDumper or MySQL Dumper, or else just set this particular database primary server to read-only, take a dump of it, and then and get the master position. So if you run this command, show master status, it will show you the master position and the file name. Now, once these two are available, we would have to use that in the secondary server. Now, coming to the replica server configuration, if you are using SSL based, you have to use a certificate in the command. And in the replica server, which is Azure database for MySQL, we have a stored procedure called as MySQL AZ Replication Change Master. There you give the name of the server, the user which you created for, with replica permission, the password, and then you give the port with which it is connected, and then you give the file position and the file name here, and also the variable for the cert which you have inserted onto the top. Right now, once you run this command, it actually configures your server, telling that your master server or the primary server is the server which is been configured here. In our case, it's another flexible server, which is the primary server there. Post that, you can just go ahead and start the replication using this stored procedure, MySQL AZ replication start. Now, if I go and look at the slave status as of now, you will find that the slave is waiting for the master. I'll just create a live database here in the primary server and see if it is getting replicated since we have already configured the replication. Now you can see it is created here. Let's come back to the replica server and then try to refresh here, and you can see that the database server got created here. I'll quickly drop the database as well for the purpose of the demo. So I just say drop the database, and you would see the database is gone from here. And once this replica gets the changes, you would see that it is going from here as well. So this is how the data-in replication works. These are the resources which is there in the description, which will give you more details about the read replicas and data-in replication. Thank you. And if there is anything further you would like to ask questions, please feel free to mail us on this email ID.